Hey Cruiser, welcome back to Cruiser Chris Craft. I'm Josh Wells, and today we are going to fix the old Lehr. It is a propane outboard motor. Don't forget to like and subscribe down below, and leave a comment if you'd like. But we are going to have a great show. So let's get started. Let's go. We are, changing the fuel line in a propane outboard engine. It's actually a little bit out of my skill set. I've never done this before. We tried to Google it. I tried to get the repair manual. I just couldn't find it. So I'm going to use my best judgment. If you're seeing what I'm doing and you know I'm doing it wrong, and you see any safety features that I'm dismantling, let me know in the comments that I need to put those back on. We're just gonna basically get this together, and then I'm gonna fill a bucket behind me. We're gonna start it and see if it goes. What's really cool about this engine is something really neat. It is, it works off of a 1 pound can of propane. It is a really cool engine. And so it works really, really well. It's a very clean engine, very fuel efficient. Off about one can, it takes maybe 2.5-3 hours of drive time off this engine. We lost our fuel line, and so we ordered a new one. I couldn't find a manual, which was really bummed me out. So it didn't look that hard. We have to take the cowling off, which I think is the hardest part. How to get this cowling off to make sure that it works. And then this fuel line basically attaches here, has another line. This is for a 20 pound can here. And then this one ties to the top, which is for the 1 pound can. This is generally how we do it. But what's cool about these is that you can refill them and you just have to chill the can first. We'll show you how to do that throughout the season. Cool. So let's grab some tools and get started on this project, because this might take a lot longer than I thought. Now you want to lay your tools out so that you know what you're holding onto. You wanna make sure that you have all your tools in one place. I don't know what size I'm gonna need, so I'm just gonna bring them all. A good set of box wrenches. What makes a good box wrench is it's easy to use. Like, these have a ratchet on the end, and they're thin, so that you can get them in really small places. I like a good thin box wrench, but if you don't have one, get one. So first thing we need to do is tear apart this engine. This engine's real easy to work on because it rotates all the way around. It spins. This is the fuel line. It's leaking right up here.
We need to take this off. This is what it looks like out of the box, right? So it doesn't have that piece on it. So we need to put that piece on here, and that's this right here. So we have the line coming down here, which then it goes to the carburetor. This is the carburetor. This is the fuel line here. Then under here, there's a line that runs all the way to the back. So I think we have to take this cowling off. There's a screw here and another one here that have to come out. And then I think there's some bolts down here after some inspection. Yeah, right here is a bolt, and then there's another one on this side. So if we take those off, I think this cowling will come off. If we do that, I think that's what our first step is.
So we need to take this screw out. So you want a small container to put your stuff in.
What's fun is I have fat little fingers, actually fat long fingers, so they're definitely in the way every time. Okay, so I got that off. So now these should just lift up, and so it's just a little pin here with a screw on it. Screw hole, lift right up. We need to figure out what that bolt is there. I'm gonna try 10 millimeter. So we're gonna use a 10 millimeter. Remember, you wanna loosen it, not tighten it. So the assembly looks like it has a washer on it and a 10 millimeter bolt. So that's one side, and there should be one more right here. So it looks like it's just held on here by that. So the fuel line itself is holding it on. So that's just a cap, and then this. Oh, real nice. It's not thin enough. I'm gonna use a 5/8 and see if I can't negotiate that in here. So you need a 5/8 on this side too. I have a very old pair of, well, pliers from my father's old toolkit. I think it was my grandfather's. This is some seriously old stuff. This is the thinnest one I have. All of my super thin tools are on the boat. Try and grab it, don't scar it, because remember, you don't wanna ruin it. I think I'm holding on to it now. Ooh. I'm hissing. I think they're full. She's off. Whew. So the cowling just comes off. Be very careful with this O-ring, but we have a much better picture of what's going on here. So this is the fuel line, and somewhere in here it cracked. So I'm gonna take this bolt off the same way I took off the other one, but the cowling's actually in really good shape. Actually in really good shape. So this is an older model. This is the 2.5, and I think it's actually, I don't think it's 5/8. It seems like it's working though. So maybe we were leaking because we were over compressed. I doubt it. So it's two flat rings, two flat bushings. Go up here to keep it tight. Yeah, I think it just break this loose and we're good. This here. So here, and then this could be tough because I don't know if I have the right size. Box wrench would be a bit better right now, but isn't that the way it works? I don't have one. I like a good thin box wrench. If you don't have one, get one. Okay, we got it now. It's tight. So we're gonna put a thread sealer on it. So there's the old one. It's cracked and damaged. Yep, it's done. Just set that one aside because it's cooked. I think this is a good opportunity to wipe it down and clean it up a little bit. Before I screw down this and this, I'm gonna put this back on here, get this all buttoned up where we want it. It's a neat little engine. If you're not familiar with the Lehr, it's a cool engine. Cool little engine. I'm trying to feel for threading so I don't cross thread it. Once it catches, you can feel it catch. A bit of confidence there, but until it catches, it's absolutely awful. My struggle is real. So I'm gonna go snug, not tight. Once I get it to where I want it, I might change that, might not. I don't really know. Now the trick is to line all these holes back up, and I think we can do that this way. Looks like it goes back pretty easily. Okay, I got one. I'm gonna put a little bit of Loctite on it. Not Loctite, it's the sealant. Remember, I'm going snug, not tight. I think I'm back together, so I'm gonna put these screws back in too. Remember, threads go to the back. These are gonna be really hard for you guys to see, but when you're in here, it makes sense. Dropped a screw. That's why I can't reach it. There's a lip. I want you guys to know, that's as close to victory as I'm ever gonna get. Victory!
Okay, so let's try it again.
I've dropped that screw in here, like, I feel like 20 times. It's unbelievably frustrating. So put your screw in before you put the screwdriver to it. That's the tip. That's the pro tip. Okay, so there's that. You want to get these semi-snug so that they don't vibrate off. So you want to make sure they're tight, but don't strip them. And then this bad boy here, I'm going to put a sealant on mine. Just a dab will do you. You don't need a whole bunch. It's pretty gross, but it goes right on. Take your time, do it right. Even if you don't have the right tools, be careful with it so you don't strip them. Remember, this is the final one here. You'll feel it bottom out. It's right there, and then there it is. Should be done. There it is. It's a lot more flexible. Now, before you start this thing, you want to make sure it doesn't leak. Listen for it. Okay. So let's fill up the bucket. Let's fill the bucket up with water. See if she starts.
6 hours later.
I think we got her.
Hey Cruiser, thanks for stopping by. We got the project done. The engine started, it's running, it's holding fuel. Hey, we did it. Don't forget to like and subscribe down below. These are amazing engines. They run forever, super clean, super good. We love you. Stay safe, be good, and stay inside. See you in a couple weeks.